Let the earth bring forth living creatures according to their kinds, livestock, creeping things, beasts of the earth according to their kinds, and it was so. Okay, but then we get very detailed attention to the personal creation of Adam, as not just, you know, hundreds of rabbits, and there they are, but Adam, one person, and then Eve, one person, showing God's personal involvement. It's not like this, and the stars. Okay, there's all the stars. It's all this detail of forming man carefully and building him from the dust of the ground, from the elements in the earth, and then breathing into him and becomes a living being, and then forming Eve and carefully and actually he made into a woman. And that's the Hebrew word that's often used of building or constructing something. He built into a woman. That's carefully formed and designed. And so there's God's great attention to detail and I think skill and personal care in the creation of us as men and women. These texts are so explicit and detailed that I really think it'd be difficult to hold to the complete truthfulness of Scripture and hold that human beings are the result of a long evolutionary process at the same time. Here's God forming man from the dust of the ground. And even more impossible to reconcile with an evolutionary view is the fact that this narrative clearly portrays Eve as having no female parent. No female parent. She was created directly from Adam's rib while Adam slept. And I say that in order to say, I understand that there are some evangelical Christians who say, well, I believe that God created everything, but he did it through the evolutionary process over billions of years, and so that human beings really descended from pre-human kinds of creatures. And then they got more complex, and pretty soon, then they eventually had language and artistic ability and creative ability and things. But the problem is, on that view, on the view that God guided it all, that view is called theistic evolution, that it's guided by God. On that view, and all evolutionary theories, the very first female human being would have been descended from some nearly human creature. That is, Eve would have had a female parent. But here, Eve has no female parent. That is, she wasn't born of some female creature that was almost human. She was formed directly out of Adam's side. And so the beginning of the human race comes with direct intervention of God. And I don't think it's consistent to hold to theistic evolution, that God guided an evolutionary process, and to say that this is true, that this narrative is true. I just was talking to people at Biola yesterday. I was over there speaking to some students and in a lecture, a group of lectures. And a few years ago, Biola went through kind of a study group and a policy determination of what you could hold and still be a faculty member there. And they ruled out theistic evolution as something that where someone could say, I believe that God guided the evolutionary process, but it still was evolution. And they said, no, I don't think we can be a faculty. You can be a faculty member here and hold that. They gave freedom on whether you think the earth is young or old, 20,000 years old or 4 billion years old. They gave freedom on that, but they didn't give freedom on theistic evolution. I don't know if you've seen one of the best-selling books in the United States right now on Amazon.com or religious books is by Francis Collins. He's the director of the Human Genome Project. And the title of the book is The Voice of God or the Language of God or what? I've seen it a couple times. The Language of God. And this is remarkable because Francis Collins is an evangelical Christian. He's I think he's Southern Baptist, but he does hold to theistic evolution. And I wish he didn't. I'm glad he's a believer. I'm glad he sees that the DNA code that's in our in our cells of our body, that he sees that as God's language, the way God expressed his wonderful wisdom in creation. And he's speaking as a Christian, and I'm sure that that book will have a positive impact for people thinking about the Christian faith because of Francis Collins' stature in terms of leading this largest DNA code unraveling project ever in the history of the human race. But I'm just saying that there are people who believe that, but I don't agree with it. I guess that's what I'm saying.